to SiO Programmer, the dedicated program for the SiO controller. Today, I'll show you how to achieve a simple automated process, pressing one button to lower a stopper and another to raise it. Let's get started. Open up the program to the main screen. As you can see, SiO Programmer can handle a lot of functions, but we're going to keep it simple with just two. The first thing you'll want to do is label your inputs and outputs. On our SiO3 controller, the green button is hooked up to input 1. The red button is hooked up to input 2. The stopper is hooked up in two places. Output 1 for the stopper being up, and output 2 for the stopper being down. Once you enter the names of your inputs and outputs, you will see that they also appear at the top. That's good, because this is where we're going to do our programming. The main thing to remember when working with SiO Programmer is this. It starts with the outputs. Ask yourself the questions, what do I want to happen to make the stopper go down? And what do I want to happen to make the stopper go up? Well, we want to push the green button for the stopper to go down and push the red button for the stopper to go up. So that's what we're going to select. The stopper being lowered is output 2. Select that line. In the next box, select in and then the green button. Now let's do the next one. The stopper being raised is output 1. Select that line. In the next box, select in and then the red button. The program is done. Let's write it over to the controller and see it in action. First, make sure your SiO controller is in the stop position. Then click write. Once the program has finished writing, switch the SiO controller to run. Now let's try our program. As you can see, the stopper will lower when you press the green button and raise when you press the red button, exactly like we wanted. For more information about the SiO Programmer or the SiO Controller series, contact SUS America Inc. at the details below.